has been pulled. Lights have been extinguished. We get green the next time by. Six cars will go 10 laps. The top four finishers will go to the spring thaw. From there, if you haven't built up enough Spring Nationals points, well, then you're going to have to watch it tonight from the trailer. Here we go with David Payne in the 8 star and Eric Wells in 18 side by side out of turn number 4. Looking for the green flag. Heat race number 1 gets that green and we're underway. David Payne will jump to the early lead. Eric Wells to the outside, Putnam on the bottom. Mac McCarter following closely. Here comes Adam Bowman now working on McCarter for the fourth and final transfer spot. Putnam to the inside of Wells. Wells will shut the door on him out of turn 4. Lap 1 goes to Payne. Payne with Wells and Putnam side by side behind him. 1 by 2 by 2 exiting turn 2. Now Wells has secured the number 2 spot. Putnam back to third. The battle for fourth between Bowman and McCarter rages on. Adam Bowman, first ever visit here, feeling pretty comfortable right now as he's holding off Mac McCarter and Robbie Moses. 10 laps the distance. David Payne showing the way. Eric Wells in that number 2 spot. Robbie Moses trying the bottom of the racetrack, doesn't pay any dividends. Four laps in the books. We'll be halfway this time. 5 in 5 to go. We are halfway in heat race number 1, and it's all David Payne. Payne looking for the 5th starting spot here tonight. That is what's on the line. 9th, 13th, and 17th will go to the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th place finishers. 6 in the books. David Payne with a half a straightaway lead over Eric Wells. Another half straightaway back to Putnam and a full straightaway to 4th place Adam Bowman. 7 laps in, the 2 to go signal when they come back by. Robbie Moses at the back battling with Mac McCarter. It's not going to get him in the show. They're going to need some help from some of the drivers in the point standings to get in. White flag the next time by. White flag coming up for David Payne and Eric Wells. Down the back chute and into turn number 4. White flag in the air, 1 to go for David Payne. Checkered flag's gonna wave. David Payne wins the event. He'll start 5th. Eric Wells will come home 2nd. 3rd will go to Josh Putnam. And his first ever visit is gonna be Adam Bowman making the big dance. So your winner of heat number 1 gathering the 5th starting spot tonight, the defending bonus series champion out of Murphy, North Carolina, driving the Gibson Motorsports Payne Excavating Base Race Fuels PPM Performance Products Interstate Welding Capital Race Car. It's the 8th star of David Payne. Eric Wells out of Hazard, Kentucky will join him, as will Florence, Alabama's Josh Putnam in 212, and the 77 out of Seymour, Indiana, Adam Bowman making his first visit to the main event of the year here to get in. So not sure if he has just missed his calling or if maybe there were mechanical problems on the Darda tire 91.
Switch payout sheets. See, I made a mistake. We bar this.
I'm good.
So it's going to be Jason Covert and Mark Vineyard on the front row. Devin Gilpin, Zach Olger, Ellery Leak, and Brad Mann. 6 cars, 10 laps, top 4 finishers advance. Here we go. Well, it was close quarters racing for Gilpin and Vineyard. They got it all figured out, and Covert's going to take the early lead. Zach Olger goes to the number 4 final transfer spot. He'll work on Gilpin. Close quarters racing out of turn 4. Gilpin will hold him off. Well, they mixed it up early. Vineyard, he was the benefactor of the exchange in turn 1 as he took over the number 2 spot, but now Gilpin has found his groove. He'll close the gap on the 4. Zach Olger's in the hot seat. He's got Ellery Leak and Brad Mann chasing him down. Olger would like to make his first visit here to Bulls Gap, a memorable one. So far, so good. Jason Covert's first ever visit here, too. Said he wanted to go to a place that put him out of his comfort zone. Looks pretty darn comfortable right now out in the lead. Covert running the bottom of the racetrack, up high, down the front stretch. He'll use the high side over in one and two. So Jason Covert has found his comfort zone real fast here. Five laps in the books, five to go. We're halfway through heat race number two. The number seven starting spot is on the line. Covert, almost a straightaway lead over second place, Mark Vineyard. Devin Gilpin solid in the number three spot, and Zach Olger feeling pretty good right now, running fourth, but he's got to hold it. Ellery Leek will try to close the gap. Two to go signal when they come back around. Devin Gilpin also making a rare appearance here at Volunteer Speedway, having a pretty good run in the number three spot. A lot of first timers out here. Brad Mann also a first timer. White flag the next time by. All Covert all the time. One lap to go. None of these drivers in the top four are in the points. They all got in on their own accord. Checkered flag waves. Jason Covert will get the number seven starting spot tonight. Mark Vineyard will come home second. Devin Gilpin will secure third. Zach Olger is going to go to the dance, finishing fourth. So Zach Olger, Devin Gilpin, Mark Vineyard make the dance and getting the win in the seventh starting spot tonight in the main event out of York Haven, Pennsylvania. In the Man Automotive, Phytech Solutions, Trick Shot Lubricant Halls, HVAC, Camera Construction, Rocket Chassis with Cornet Power, driving a Mustang GT, it's the Shade Mountain Assassin, Jason Covert in the number 72. Front row. Looks like seven cars here will take the green. Billy Ogle Jr. not answering the bell. So some drivers having some trouble here tonight, most of them starting towards the back. How is it out there, guys? Is it relatively warm? All right, good. The racing action about to heat up right here in turn number four as Satterley and McDowell bring him out of that corner and Green is out. Greg Satterley with the advantage and Cody Mahoney grabbed the number two spot, but McDowell stole it back on the inside and we're going again. Cars, 10 laps, top four finishers will go to the spring thaw. And this time they are bunched up side by side. Great looking start, green flag in the air. So again, it's Satterley with the advantage. This time Dale McDowell used the high side and he'll springboard into the lead. McDowell the leader, Satterley second, Mahoney third, and Douglas fourth. Lap number one's gonna go to the Mac Daddy, but here comes Greg Satterley. Satterley on the bottom, McDowell on the high side, two distinctly different lines. And it's working for Dale McDowell up top right now. On the bottom in four, on the top in one and two, he opened up the door, but Satterley couldn't walk through the threshold. So McDowell will show the way. Now Satterley's going to get in his tire tracks. Greg Satterley settling into the number two spot. Sixth starting spot is on the line tonight, and it's McDowell right now with that sixth starting spot. Fourth and final transfer position belonging to Mark Douglas in the 52D. Halfway this time for McDowell. Five in, five to go. Satterley still poised in the number two spot. Satterley would get the 10th starting position if he finishes in second. Sixth spot up for grabs. Dale McDowell still has it by five car lengths over Satterley. Six in the books, four to go. They have separated themselves from the battle for third between Cody Mahoney and Mark Douglas. Two to go signal when they come back around. Satterley still five car lengths off the rear deck lid of Dale McDowell. White flag the next time by. McDowell's showing the way. Satterley in the number two spot. Now Douglas to the inside of Mahoney for third. Good battle for the third spot. White flag in here, one to go. Out of four, they come side by side. Mahoney, a half a car length over Douglas. McDowell's gonna win it. Satterley's gonna come home second. We'll see how it ends up for third. Mahoney has taken third and held third. Here comes Douglas one more time at the line. Cody Mahoney by a nose. He'll start 14th. Douglas will settle for the 18th starting spot. So your winner of heat race, number three, the veteran out of Chickamauga, Georgia, and the Boyd built, Dale McDowell Driving School, University of Northwestern Ohio, Klotz Synthetic Lubricants, Boyd Speedway, Kometic Gaskets, and Bad Boy Off-Road, number 17M, it's the Mac Daddy Dale McDowell. Dirt Demon Donald McIntosh on the pole into his outside scrub Rick Eckert in the number seven. Rick Eckert, the World of Outlaws Craftsman Late Model Series champion, won it on the final night at the dirt track at Charlotte about 5 years ago. As Josh Richards, the point leader, had a right rear flat tire, Eckert went on with a 12th place finish to claim his only World of Outlaws title. Let's see what he does here as the green comes out. Side by side at the line, McIntosh on the bottom, Eckert on the high side. McIntosh will take the early lead, Eckert to second, Buckingham third, here comes Jake O'Neill in the zero. Lap number one is gonna go to McIntosh. McIntosh showing away, Eckert second, and now Buckingham has got himself a battle with Jake O'Neill. Stacy Bowles, first car on the outside, looking in the 11B. Donald McIntosh starting to open up the advantage now over Scrub. Fourth and final transfer spot belongs to Jake O'Neill. Robbie Moses, his teammate, is running in that second spot, Shannon Buckingham. Buckingham doing a good job running third, that is. Bowles still on the outside looking in along with Jordan Horton and the eight of Chandler. Stacy Bowles has caught the fourth and final transfer car of Jake O'Neill. He's still got four laps to figure it out. McIntosh bringing it out of turn number four. Two to go signal when they come back around. White flag the next time by as Donald McIntosh showing away. Rick Eckert in the number two spot. Shannon Buckingham third and running for Jake O'Neill. White flag in the air, one to go for McIntosh. Down the back stretch and into turn number three for the final time. Checkered flag a wave. Your winner of heat number four, Donald McIntosh. Rick Eckert will come home second. Shannon Buckingham will take third, and a fourth and final transfer spot will go to Jake O'Neill. Unofficially, your two provisional starters will be the 11B of Stacy Bowles, getting the 21st starting spot. Robbie Moses will get the 22nd starting spot.